In the last movie, you started cleaning up the Revit model in anticipation of exporting it to 3ds Max. Another part of the process is adding and removing detail where needed. Sometimes it's easy to pinpoint the problem, other times they only become apparent once you're in 3ds Max. Continue working on your Revit project, or use the file 02museumcurtainwalls.rvt if you need to catch up. The project has two types of curtain walls. One is made of clear glass, the other seems semi-transparent in Revit, made of frosted glass, but will make it opaque in 3ds Max. However, the material is not the concern right now. We're mostly interested in the geometry. It looks fine in Revit, but let's take a look at it in 3ds Max. In the last movie, you created an FBX file you named mycurtainwalls.fbx that you're ready to link to 3ds Max. If you didn't have Revit and weren't able to create the FBX file, you can use the one provided to you, 02museumcurtainwalls.fbx. In 3ds Max or 3ds Max Design, make sure your system units are set to feet, as discussed at the beginning of this tutorial. Also, set the display units to feet with fractional inches to match the Revit display. You can set it to metric if you're more comfortable. Display units are quite forgiving. Use Import Link FBX to link the museum FBX file. Use the Combine by Family Type option for this example and attach the file. You will be prompted for a daylight system, and say yes for now. It'll be some time yet before we worry about rendering. If you're using 3ds Max or 3ds Max Design 2015, you'll probably need to relocate or redock the Scene Explorer. Dismiss or move away the links dialog. Zoom in on the building and take a closer look at the curtain walls. The curtain wall on the lower level is made of clear glass and the panels are there to show it. However, there are currently no mullions separating the glass panels. Although you usually want to limit the number of polygons in a 3D scene, you still want to have important detail where you need it. Mullions are important, and we need to see them if and when the camera gets closer to the wall. On the other hand, we want opaque panels on the upper level of the curtain wall, perhaps with a hint of a grout between them. Usually, such a grout can easily be simulated with a bump map in 3ds Max. Currently, even though the upper curtain wall is a single object, it is still made of a multitude of polygons. So, where you need to add detail to the lower curtain wall in the form of mullions, you need to remove detail from the upper curtain wall to simplify the geometry. You will rely on materials to simulate the tiling effect. So, go back to Revit to make the necessary changes. Start with the grid lines you need to remove on the blue curtain walls. Select the blue wall section. It is defined as curtain wall 10 feet. You can directly edit this family type or make a copy if you plan to revisit it later. Click the Edit Type button and duplicate the type. Name the duplicate curtain wall no grid lines. Set the vertical and horizontal grid layouts to none to prevent the creation of grid lines. Click OK to exit. You get a caution reminding you to completely delete the grid lines from this family type. Accept the recommendation. The grid lines have disappeared, but the glazing seems to have reverted to clear glass. Click an empty area to make sure all objects are deselected. Hover over the curtain wall section you worked on and press Tab until only the perimeter gets highlighted, then click the mouse button. This selects the glass part of the curtain wall assembly. Switch the glazing again from clear to frosted. Repeat on the opposite side and at the front of the building. At this point, you could take a moment and edit the frosted glass material if you're comfortable with Revit. If you're more comfortable with 3ds Max, you can also edit the material there. I will choose the second option in this tutorial, simply to emphasize that both methods are valid. So, leave the frosted glass material for now and concentrate on the mullion creation process. To start with, I would suggest making the clear glass curtain walls more consistent. The roof sections seem to be based on a 10-foot spacing. we'll switch them to the 6-foot spacing as in the lower levels. Since we're at it, let's add a few door openings as well. For that, go to the Architecture tab and choose Curtain Grid. By default, it is set to work across all segments. This is fine for now. Set a grid line to be 7 feet high. Repeat on all other roof walls. Click the Modify button to exit the command, and click an empty area to deselect all objects. Hover and use the Tab key to select the panels where you want to have doors. Switch the panel type to use the storefront double door system. Repeat where needed. To create mullions out of grid lines, first you need to have a mullion type defined. Expand the scene browser and the curtain wall mullions category. You'll use a simple rectangular type. Right-click Rectangular Mullion and choose New Type. Name it 2x4. Once you've named it, right-click to edit its properties. Set the thickness or depth to 4 inches. Notice that you have two width values. The sum of both values must equal the overall width you want to have. Here, we need a 2-inch width, so you can set the values to 1 inch on each side of a center line. For a material, you can create a new one or use an existing one. In this case, you can simply use the railing polished material. Once you have defined a mullion type, you can use it to replace grid lines on curtain walls. This is done by going to the Architecture tab and clicking the Mullion button. You then select a mullion type, in this case the one you just created and named 2x4. You can then choose to replace a grid line, a grid segment, or all grid lines on a curtain wall section. Save your file when you're done. More importantly, you need to update the FBX file you already linked to 3ds Max. Use the Export to FBX feature to override the file you created earlier and that you named mycurtainwalls.fbx. Go back to 3ds Max. Your scene has not updated yet. Use References, Manage Links to access the Links dialog again. Go to the Files tab and notice the red flag indicating the FBX file has changed. Click the Reload button. A settings dialog appears. Arguably, the most important options here relate to materials. My advice is to always retain 3ds Max material adjustments on reload so that any material tweaking in 3ds Max is not lost. Once the file is reloaded, you should notice significant differences. The redundant opaque panels are gone, and now you have additional geometry in the form of mullions and doors. In the next movie, you take a look at stairs and railings.